The nets are up. The capture kits are ready. The birds' solar-powered tracking backpacks are all set to go. And any second now, the sun will come up. Let's go find some birds.
I'm Greg Golet, senior scientist for the Nature Conservancy. And these are my notes from the field.
Less than 200 years ago, California's Central Valley was visited by 70 to 100 million migratory water birds each year. Why did they come? Because historically, this area was home to 4 million acres of diverse, dynamic wetlands. But today, more than 90% of those wetlands are gone. And in the last 50 years, North America's bird populations have declined by approximately 3 billion birds. But the migratory birds that remain still follow their age-old instincts to land in the Central Valley to rest and refuel. How do we solve this problem? Well, it would take incredible sums of money to buy all the habitat these birds need. But they only really need it during their migration. So the Nature Conservancy hit on an idea. Why buy the bird habitat when you can just rent it? We could work with farmers who would be paid to create seasonal water bird habitats by flooding their fields to shallow depths after harvest, just what these birds need. So in 2014, a group of conservation organizations came together to try this out. The Nature Conservancy, Point Blue Conservation Science, and Audubon California formed the Migratory Bird Conservation Partnership. And we worked with the California Rice Commission to create and launch BirdReturns. BirdReturns is an incentive program that provides temporary habitats for migratory birds when and where they need it most. The program is focused on shorebirds, whose populations have declined by 40% in the last 50 years. They're actually one of the most imperiled groups of birds in all of North America. Birds are a critical part of the Earth's ecosystem. They support our planet by pollinating plants, distributing seeds, and keeping bugs and rodents in check.
All right, it's 5:35. We ready?
Last night, we put up giant mist nets over the fields where the birds come to feed in the morning. And now we're up before dawn to recruit some feathered travelers for our study. But we must do it quickly because soon it will be light and then they'll see the net. Our study is focused on two migratory shorebirds, the Dunlin and the long-billed Dowitcher. These robin-sized shorebirds migrate each year from their summer Arctic breeding grounds to warmer climates where they spend the winter. And for both species, this rest stop in the Central Valley is key. We have one item for some birds to take with them when they are released, a tiny solar-powered radio transmitter that they can carry with them like a backpack. Each backpack weighs less than 3% of the bird's body weight to have as minimal an impact as possible on their flight. But these tiny packs are a critical part of the study. They communicate with a network of receiving towers installed by the Nature Conservancy and partners across California and all the way up to Alaska, where the birds head each year to build their nests and raise their chicks. Our goal in this study is to answer a lot of questions. Where do the birds go? How fast do they travel? How much food do they need? Are they doing well enough to breed and return to California so they can do it all over again? And ultimately, are we doing enough to protect these species? The data from the radio transmitters, paired with our findings on stress levels and body fat, will help us answer these questions. We've seen real successes from bird returns, and now it's time to amplify that. This program isn't just good for birds, it's good for people. In addition to helping Central Valley farmers provide these habitats, BirdReturns is helping California effectively manage one of our most critical resources, water. The flooding of fields and remaining wetlands for the birds helps to recharge groundwater, a critical resource that Californians depend upon during droughts. Migratory birds and people are suffering from habitat loss and water shortages all over the world. Our goal is to make this program work as effectively and efficiently as possible and to make it adaptable so the benefits it provides can be realized far and wide. Because when it comes to maintaining the world's ecosystems, we need migratory birds just as much as they need us.